When Gareth Southgate dropped Trent Alexander-Arnold from his England squad for this international break, he made one of the most controversial selection decisions of his England tenure so far. By not picking Alexander-Arnold now, Southgate has thrown into doubt whether Alexander-Arnold will be involved this summer. If there's any consolation for Trent, it is that the gaffer, in the recent past, has dropped Kyle Walker and Kieran Trippier, and they have both played their way back into his plans. Alexander-Arnold is paying the price for a difficult season in which, like plenty of Liverpool players, he has looked physically and mentally drained after playing at such a high level for so long. England have so many good players in this area that some have to miss out, and in this instance, it is Alexander-Arnold. Maybe the delay of the Euros has come at a bad time for Alexander-Arnold, given how well he was playing in 2019-20 before the stoppage, but now he finds himself in a position no one expected, with the possibility of missing out on the tournament held this summer. Southgate's explanation that Alexander-Arnold has paid the price for a slump in form at a time when James and Trippier have had exceptional seasons. COVID-19 wrecked his preseason and he was left playing catch-up. He struggled for rhythm at times and was unable to provide Klopp's frontline with the usual array of quality from the right flank. His confidence was clearly dented. A calf injury suffered against Manchester City forced him to miss the November internationals and kept him out for a month. Having contributed 4 goals and 15 assists for Liverpool last season, this time around, he has only managed 1 goal and 5 assists across 34 appearances in all competitions. The feeling persists that Southgate has never fully trusted Alexander-Arnold and wants a more defensively minded right back. He has started just 10 internationals under Southgate and has come off the bench on 2 occasions. Although Liverpool and Alexander-Arnold himself have dropped off by their extraordinary standards of last season, comparing Alexander-Arnold's creativity against his peers shows he is still right up there. Alexander-Arnold's 0.23 expected assists per 90 minutes remains the best among his positional peers this season. That figure means the quality of his passes would expect him to get an assist once every 4 games. Meanwhile, his well-known crossing ability is bettered only by James, whose numbers show why he has rightfully retained his place in the England setup. Having a good delivery from wide areas is a highly useful trait in international football, where chances can be at a premium, and the ability to get the ball quickly into dangerous areas can make the difference. Some have criticized Alexander-Arnold's defensive awareness, but his 3.5, true, interceptions are by no means bottom of the class, and shows his ability to read the game well and get in good defensive positions. His 5.0 true tackles per 1,000 opponent touches show that he is not as likely to put a foot in compared with his right-back peers. However, when he does engage in the challenge, his tackle win rate is a respectable 65%, behind the unbeatable Aaron Wan-Bissaka. If Southgate honestly doesn't think he's worth a place in the squad, then you really have to question the judgment of the man at the helm.